I still ain't got nothing bad to say about that man, because I ain't never, that man ain't never did me no wrong, but he killed my daughter.
Come on in this house.
Welcome back to the Label Black Podcast. This is Bit Boy the Boss, aka the Money Quarterback, making plays with the money. What up, Bit? What it do, everyone? The value ain't in you. It is in you. It ain't on you.
Okay. What it do, Dante?
Yo, what's good, everybody? Just remember, look in the mirror every morning. Just say you're beautiful.
What up, John?
What up, you guys? What up?
Man, we got a special guest returning again. What's up, ShellJ?
Hey.
Yo. Got the shades on looking like a stunner. Shakira, what's up in the background?
And Bradley. What's up? What's up?
Sister and brother over there. Well, how you Hold been? Out.
I'm okay. I'm making it.
You're just making it. So with the trial like coming to an end, like how did you feel about the verdict and the charges? I mean, not the charges, but the sentence.
I mean, I wanted life for a life, really. My baby was snatched, so, but it'll do.
So like you was like more in favor of a death penalty, what you were saying?
I ain't gonna say the death penalty, but I mean, 48 years is a long time too, so.
I would say that's a long time, that's life, you yeah. know, that's.
But I guess I wasn't satisfied because like, he's the only one locked up, you know? Like, it was more people involved.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of more people involved. So I just feel like everybody should be held accountable. Oh, I look like Ray Charles. Let me get right.
But so say like you said everybody should be held accountable.
Yeah.
So that do you feel like the charges that he got was enough? So I feel like everybody got put in the same bracket. So like nobody else got caught. So like he the person that had to take the bear the brunt. So what you feel about that? Like I feel like do you feel like the police still gonna be looking for other people?
Yeah, oh of course. Like it's still an open investigation even though he has been sentenced because at the end of the day he's my baby killer. So, you know, but in the state of South Carolina it's the hands of one, the hands of all. So I don't really understand it because, you know, I look at TV a lot and the justice system does not work how we think it works, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I really didn't think Lexi kind of was doing their job. Because of like how I had my ear to the streets and how I was finding that stuff, I'm feeling like how they don't know it, you know. But once I got to court, it was a whole nother ball game. Like we know, they know everything.
Yeah.
They know who started it, who brought who, where it started at. You know, so they know
so
names.
They really did their job.
They did their job. They did their job. They know names, but it's just like at the end of the day, it's still so much that they can do. You know, they know, but they just can't. Like I ain't gonna say they can't prove it, but they need. Basically proof, witnesses, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
All the people that's posting all these statuses on social media got so much to say because justice for TASHYA MICHELLE JAY. You know, y'all could have been putting y'all mouth towards getting other people in there like I've been screaming since day one, you know? So.
But like I said, me personally, I know people look at the situation saying like they wouldn't just quote unquote turn themselves in because like they look at the situation saying I listened to a lot of stuff yesterday too, like if I didn't mean to do something, why would I say I did something that I didn't even mean to do and I don't even know I did it?
Yeah.
Because I don't know. How I look at it, I always had a lot of mouth. You know what I'm saying? I'm always messy, as they say, but I never mess it with lies. I'm always messing with the truth. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So it's a difference. But I've been learned how to ride my own wave, how to flow my own thing. You know what I'm saying? I learned how to stay out of the number. Stop, have your name and everything, ShellJ.
Yep.
Sit down, you know what I'm saying? And that's what I've been doing for the last couple of years. So it's just like, when it first happened.
Yeah, it's like, it just been a year or whatever. Like, do you feel like you progressing mentally?
Oh, yeah. Honestly, I feel like I'm built for this shit. Like, I ain't going to say I don't have my days, you know, because it's a tragic situation. Mm-hmm. And, like, I never took a loss. Like, I mean, the only person in my life that I lost was my granddaddy.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So, he was old. You know, it was expected. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't really expected. But when you old, you know what happens. You done lived your life. So, it's just like my baby was snatched so quick. So, I just had to sit back and reevaluate and just, like, I look at life differently now. Like, I ain't gonna say I'm a saint, I'm this, I go to church. None of that, I don't. You know what I'm saying? But it's just like, it made me look at stuff a lot differently because I took a lot of stuff for granted. Mm-hmm. Like, you know what I'm saying? I always thought, I always gotta run my mouth, I always gotta do this, I always gotta do that. No, Shell, you can sit back, hush sometimes, you know?
Yeah.
You know, shit gonna play out. So it's like, it making me learn and making me wanna, like, speak out more. You know what I'm saying? I always had a lot of mouth. So is this a way for me to use it? You
exactly.
know?
Positive, right?
You know, so I got a lot to say, you know, and I just feel like I got to use it in the way that I need to use it for my baby, because she going to always be a part of me. She came from me. Exactly. You know what I'm saying? So
her legacy going to always live on.
Yeah. Right. And I was thinking, because like when I first heard the sins or whatever, because I'm a compassionate person or whatever. So like, I just feel, I always try to see the good in everybody. Like, man, 48 years. But then I thought about, Shell, daughter never gonna see the prom.
Never.
Like, she never gonna get the, like, you know, see, you never gonna get to see her go to the prom, like, graduate or nothing. And like, so, like, at the end of the day, like, when you make decisions and you put yourself in the situation, that's just how it goes.
Exactly. Gotta live with the consequences.
My baby's supposed to be 13 in September. And I'm saying, you had to know her to know. Like, if you know, you know. You know, my other daughter's nothing like her. You know what I'm saying? She tried to be, but it ain't her, you know.
Yeah,
it was
him.
It was then Shia. It was then. Like, I ain't have to tell my girl to go put her earrings on. I ain't have to tell my girl to put them clothes on. Girl, we about to go, cause she gonna put it on. She know what's up, you know. Mom, I want my hair did. Mom, I want my nails did. You know, I've never been a nail person, but she always been that person. I used to be like, Shia, you so extra, you know, just like, why
it
you
just
so
was
extra?
Her. It just
it
her.
Was her. Yeah. It was her. You know, I never could remember a time my baby was mad. Mm-hmm. I could whoop her ass, cuss her out, cause that's me. I'm a cuss. Period. But you know what I'm saying? It's just like, she never was a sad child, or, you know what I'm saying, always complaining. She used what she had and just went with it, you know? Yeah. You always going to be a Shia.
Like,
no matter where we go, I'm
going to
call her name 10 times. I promise you. Shia. Shia.
Shia. I see that everywhere, and it's so tight. Cause when I saw her with the bench, it's the middle school, right?
Elementary
school. Yeah. It's like so cool to me. It's like, oh, God, like, she's going to be sitting there forever remembering. Like, all the kids are going to pass through, and like, you're going to see her name. And then you can always ask the question, who is she? And you're going to hear the story and just know that she's somebody to be honored.
Yeah, it's like, and it's such a great thing, like, how many people she touched while she was here on earth. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, for
real. And with Shell J being her mama, they can't take that from her. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people love my baby.
Yeah.
And I didn't even know my baby had met all these people. But she stayed, want to go somewhere. She loved the church. I never took her. But anybody that go to church, she going to call them. Can I go with you? Can you drop me off? Her little cousin died like a month or two before she got killed. And she committed suicide. She was only 12 in Johnston. And she begged me to go to the funeral. I'm like, no, Shia, you ain't going to that funeral. But that jump was weird to me. Like, please, mama, can I go? I'm going to be okay. Can I go?
She wanted to pay her respect.
Me? And I dropped off with her grandma to that funeral. They said she cried like a baby. After that, she was good. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, it's just like, it's a lot of stuff I look back on like, damn. You know, was she here to teach me a lesson? You know, because they say everybody got their days, everybody got their numbers. And I still don't understand it. I still don't. I don't know nothing about church because I never grew up in it, you know.
Yeah.
Like, everybody say pray. I don't know how to pray, but I know I dropped to my knees now. Since
you just got to believe.
Know, you feel me? I know. They say get on pray, your knees, right? Or whatever, however you want to do it, and talk. So that's what I try to do. And it's like stuff getting a little better, but it'll never be the same, you know. And I'm only 30. So it's just like, but you know, I'm getting beautiful with time, you know.
You look good to me. Time, you never going to heal fully from that tragic situation, because that's a missing piece of your heart that's always never going to be there. So, like, you just got to, like I say, have good days, be happy, be positive. And like, I saw you on Pig Snap last week twerking. I'm like, look at Shell J. She must be like, you know, feeling a little bit better in life. So, like, tell us that. You moving, like, how has life been? Like, so with time, it heals a little bit. The pain eases a little bit.
I ain't going to say that, because every day is a struggle. I'm going to say, like, I get up in the morning, like, but I always been a strong person. Let me say that first. You feel what I'm saying? Like, I always, like, now that I sit back and look at my life, I always been, like, different. Like, I always been big, but you could never call me the big girl, because, big, what's
you
up?
Confident.
Like,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I'm popping my shit back. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm popping it back. So I always taught my kids that too. No matter what nobody call you, baby, you beautiful. You like Shia was dark. So everybody always wanted to call her dark, wanted to call her black, chocolate. Okay, baby, yeah, you beautiful.
Beautiful.
What's up?
Yeah,
so you gotta take everything with it. So it's just like, I always been different. So now that this didn't happen, it's just like, damn, was I building myself for this, you know? Cause I ain't gonna say I don't have my bad days, but once I cry about it, I'm bouncing back. Like, you know, I look at it like I didn't do nothing wrong. But I still blame myself, because I always been that aggressive person. Mm-hmm. I always been that person. You ain't gonna touch nobody when I'm around. What's up? Yeah, you gonna say you whoop her in, Shell J. Like, that's just how I go. You not doing nothing to nobody around me when I'm around. So it's just like, You know how they say neighborhood hero. To have my baby snatched like that. I always felt like that could never happen.
You can't do nothing about it.
You feel me? That could never happen to me. And nah, I ain't rubbing nobody doing nothing.
I think about that with you all the time. Like, it's such like a movie though. It's like you see movies when like somebody lose their child or whatever in that kind of situation, and to know you went through that and like you still like
have going
to
through it
every day. And, like, I can't even imagine how they do feel though.
Because when I heard about the sentence yesterday, the 48 years, the first person I thought about was you or whatever. Because, like, I mean, the whole trial was like about TASHYA, but pretty much pertains to you. So I was like, I would love to talk to ShellJ and feel her thoughts or whatever. And then ShellJ had hit me up, and this is how all this got set up. Because it's crazy, you speak it, believe it, receive it. You feel me? Because like, I literally want to talk to her. I told her that in DM, like, I ain't want to be rude and be like, you want to come on the podcast and talk about it. But we did want to talk about it because you came on the podcast. And, like, we all connected because we know both sides. So, like, we try to stay, like, unbiased. But we try to, like, we're going to definitely lean more to the side of justice. You know, like, 48 years is a lot of years. It's like, damn, we know Ace. Like, he was a good dude. We liked him and stuff like that. You know,
and
like,
that's the thing. That's a whole nother thing, too. That's why I hit you up, because once I speak on it this time, I got to learn how to move on from Michelle. Yeah. You ain't always got to be heard. You feel what I'm saying? Like, they feel you. If they don't feel you, period. It's just that simple. But at the end of the day, I know Quayshawn. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I done been around this man. I done seen this man diffuse the situation. Mm-hmm. When they first told me Ace was the one killed my baby, no, Ace ain't did that.
You can't believe it, exactly.
Ace ain't did that.
Yeah.
You feel me? But when I started, oosh, I'm back. Okay, but when I first found out Ace was my killer on some real stuff, though, like, nah, Ace.
He just so laid back to me, cool. Like, I never even saw him in a mad way. I mean,
you feel me?
Me,
like, I done seen this man when I used to be at Marvin House or something. Like, I done seen this man, or if I'm at Talika House getting my hair did, I done seen this man, like, somebody showing up, he going to calm them down.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, the only thing I wanted to know, like, what happened that night? You get what I'm saying? Yeah. Because the proof is there. So, it's nothing that we can take from it, even though we hate the fact that it's him. His bullet killed my daughter.
So it's 100% fact that it is.
100% fact.
I read that it was 0.762 bullet size.
Yeah, he admitted to shooting that gun. He admitted that that was his bullet.
So, like I say, the decisions you make, I had this word that I wanted to bring up to everyone, that you need to think about discernment. It's the ability to judge well. And like I say, you got your judgments are what your decisions are. And like, you got to live by them, because there's a lot of situations that you couldn't be in. You didn't have to pull the trigger. You didn't have to beat it at night. You didn't have to feel like you had to do that. And like I say, whatever happens, happens. Like, yeah, you got to just deal with it.
My thing is, like, why is y'all was like, I ain't showing out in the trailer park like that. Like, all that type of stuff. Like, you want to do that shit, go to like a big ass open field where ain't
nobody around.
Well, I'm about to say, well, it's just y'all. Like, leave that shit alone. Like, that shit ain't.
But, like, it happened so fast that, like, you got to stay in the house or whatever. Yeah. So, like, they ain't even a part of it. They just enjoying their life and their peace or whatever.
Exactly.
And, like, the ruckus get brought to them. So, like, what they supposed to not. I saw a statement that said it should be time served. Like, time served for what?
Man, ain't no way.
But see, okay, my bad.
He served, kind of like. Somebody don't get to be here forever. You got to live a life where, like, you missing a piece of you every single day. People get to be out here smiling jolly with theirs. And, like, I can't.
And that's what I'm saying. Like, honestly, y'all, I always keep screaming since it happened June the 9th. Justice for my baby. Justice for my baby.
Right.
And they been had him in jail since June the 11th. So why am I still screaming justice for my baby if this man is in jail? He's not getting a bun. Da-da-da. Because I knew it's more people involved once I heard the story.
Yep.
But once it first, you know what I'm saying? When it first was, oh, that a kid got killed, everybody was so sentimental. But when it's ShellJ kid, oh, ShellJ followed them boys to the Manetta store. ShellJ followed them boys to Rocket Lane. Baby, why didn't ShellJ stop them if I knew my kids was there? Make stuff make sense.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I ain't new to this mother thing. I been doing this thing. My baby was, she supposed to be 13. Like I said, she was 11 when she got killed.
Mm-hmm.
So I had been doing this thing 11 years. You never seen my kids with me. Even if I'm coming to be nosy, I'm not bringing my kids because I know how she get.
Yeah.
I know how she work. I don't know. Like, I can't say I know all the people that was all outside of Bull Yard.
Yeah.
Like that. Mm-hmm. Because them boys young. You get what I'm saying? But I know of them. I can, when I see them in the streets, huh? I'm eyeballing them, show lives, because baby, you shouldn't even be out here. You shouldn't even be walking. But the other side, the other people, I know everybody in their yard.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody, including the mastermind.
Yeah.
Including the mastermind. I just had to fight the mastermind Portrait Festival night, May.
Yep.
Because this man walked up on me. This man walked up on me saying stuff to me. You feel what I'm saying? And you, I just say this say man. What he said? Oh, not really, because you feel me? Like it is what it is, because I handled it. You know what I'm saying? But it's just the point of, I just don't understand how people so mad at me for wanting justice for my innocent 11-year-old. I don't care what y'all portray me to be. Yeah. I don't care nothing about that. I didn't even know none of the shit was, the junk was going on, because I would have been out the door, honestly. Like, no, y'all better not do that junk out here. You feel me? It wouldn't have been no questions asked who had a gun, because I'm telling who had a gun. Oh, just like that, like my baby was ducking, okay? These are facts. Look at the news. These are facts. My baby was 5'3". The bullet that killed her was 3 to 4 feet from the ground coming out of the refrigerator.
That means she was squatting.
She was squatting. Mm-hmm. My baby thought she was protecting instead of hitting the grind. Instead of, I said, I'm like, Shia, Maya, don't move. Get down. Don't move. You feel me? Because they on two separate parts of the house. I'm saying, don't move. Get down. I never seen her come out that room, though, you know? I never heard my baby say, Mama. I never heard my baby say nothing. The bullet that went in my baby head went straight in right here, stopped right here in the back of her head. Killed her instantly. Killed her instantly.
And you guess what? Like, you saw that, and so you supposed to feel like it needs just need to be served with a little bit of time. Like, that's, I understand.
Like, come on.
You saw that. Like,
at the end of the day, yes, he's a good dude, okay? That what y'all say? Yeah, he's a good dude. But everybody is accountable for what they do. You got to pay for it. Somebody got to take accountability here. Yep. And not only him, everybody. Every single person.
Because two people got shot.
You feel me? They won't beef with me. That's why I don't understand. That's why I want all the smoke. Any of it. Period. Because at the end of the day, as they say, well, it was gang related. The biggest number one rule, I don't know nothing about the gang stuff, but the number one rule is kids, ain't it?
You don't touch them.
Come on. Make it make sense. Y'all be contradicting your own self. You get what I'm saying? And it don't make sense to me. Because how I feel, y'all gonna have to say it with my baby, because my mind real ruthless. What's up? What's up? Like,
but like, you ain't gotta go to that point, because like, be positive.
Because like, other the boy from Baseburg, you know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't even know it was a problem with me and you, but you put up a whole status. You feel me? I can't tell nobody what to put. I can't. Y'all do what y'all do. I just know how to move after. You feel me? Okay, but when you put, she could have still been here. She could have still been here if what? Make it make sense, baby. So when I jump in your inbox instead of commenting on your status, you be a whole hoe. I said what I said. Check my snap. Check my snap. Baby, your snap is lies. This man turned himself in. Baby. No. The news report shows what? He bought new cell phones. They tracked this man through his new cell phone.
The next day.
June 10th.
The next day. Secret Service tracked him through his cell phone towers. Picked them up where they picked them up from. Like, how did he turn himself in? You feel me? Like, come on now. And I still ain't got nothing bad to say about that man, because I ain't never, that man ain't never did me no wrong, but he killed my daughter.
Yep.
He killed my daughter.
Even if he ain't mean to.
Even if he didn't mean to.
Like.
You feel what I'm saying? But the hands of one is the hands of all.
That's right.
The hands of one is the hands of all. And if it wasn't an investigation, I will, you know, open investigation still. I would state their names. But not everybody know names. Oh, y'all better talk before I talk. You know how many times I've seen that yesterday? I'm like, you know what? At this point, it's been a whole year, baby. If y'all ain't talk, y'all ain't talk.
Y'all ain't gonna talk.
Now y'all want to talk, and y'all want to blame me. So I'm responding back, you know?
What you mean blame you, though? Cause like,
they want to blame me for wanting justice, for getting justice for my daughter.
That's why. I read that kind of stuff, and I be like, I don't understand that at all, because like, you should. Why wouldn't you want justice for your daughter? You lost a piece of your heart. Like, you lost a piece.
Even if it's an accident, they don't mean that. Like I was saying earlier, if you get your arm cut out, it could be an accident, but you still lost your arm. Yep. You still got to deal with the consequences of losing your arm every day. So even if you didn't mean to kill somebody, you still
killed.
Like I say, I know a lot of people talking about the time length, and like, for me, yeah, that's a lot of time, because we know Ace, he our age, and like, dang, like he gonna be gone for that long from his kids too. Like, but you also gotta think about Shell's perspective. She gone from her kid for life.
Yeah.
So that's why, like, I mean, we can't feel how Shell feel. Cause if my kid was in that situation, I probably want the same thing.
You want the same thing.
Yeah, you know the same exact thing. So like, you, it's hard to put yourself in the same position because you're not in that position to be even giving your opinion on how you would feel in that position, like how Shell feel. Because I mean, say if your daughter got raped or killed, because I feel like in the same sense, like, you're going to feel so violated that and disrespect that you want death or either that person not to ever see the light of day again. Yeah. Get it?
And this is how it go.
And the, but the thing is though, like, they so mad, but Ace apologized when he got up yesterday in court. So it's like, y'all, like, have y'all talked to him? You know, at the end of the day, that's how I be feeling with some of the shit. Like, have y'all talked to Ace? Yeah. Because Ace would chop y'all out here, showing out like this, trying to come at me, even though I want all the smoke. You know what I'm saying? But it just shows people heart. It just shows, like, what kind of people is. You know what I'm saying? Like, it really does.
They don't care about the other person in the situation. That was
they try to find a flaw for everything. What's the flaw? What's the flaw? Me and my kids was only there 10, 15 minutes. You know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, we had to just, when it got something, we just woke up. Me, that what we did. You ain't seen me on no scene. Can't nobody in Rocky Lane say they seen Shell J unless they see me going in Bug House until my baby was killed. And they got on the stand and testified that. They seen me. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they seen me.
Yeah.
But when the police went to y'all house was pitch black dark. The police had to bam on the door for y'all to come to the door. But y'all mothers, you feel me? Like,
they all just ran in and just
locked the door. You feel me?
So doing
and
the
then one person got on stand and said she seen me walking down the road. They seen somebody coming down the road. They said, well, who was that? They said, Shell J. They said, how you know her? We grew up together. He said, you grew up in Batesburg, Rich Brain. Yeah, bitch. Oh, y'all, I'm sorry. But y'all, we grew up together. We grew up together. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, dang. Like, I know that's your whatever, but at the end of the day, like, you a mother. Yeah, you a mother. Y'all know I ain't had nothing to do with what y'all had going on.
Yeah.
Nothing. I didn't even know what was going on.
Even if you did, that but doesn't even justify killing anybody.
I know, but it's like, it hit a little different, though. Like, if I brought my baby down, baby, you got to, I'm going to really blame myself. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
You know, but I didn't bring my baby down there. Every day, anybody can say you that. No, me and Bull. If you see Shell, you're going to see Bull. You see Bull, you're going to see Shell.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
You know, we got two daughters around the same ages. We hang together. We chill together every single day. So that's what we did. That's what we do. You get
it's
what I'm saying?
Like I said, it's just a regular night for y'all. And
regular
then,
night. Yeah. Regular night. Regular night. You feel me? Yeah, I knew it was something going on at Talika house. Because I seen it on Snap. But, okay, I wasn't going over there. You know what I'm saying? So it was okay. But I never knew all that beef was going on. Like, I don't be into that gang junk or that, none of that. So I don't know nothing about it until I hear about it. You know? So I didn't know none of that was going on. I didn't know it was so much beef going on.
Yeah.
Or them boys supposed to have it out. You know, I would've, boy, let's go. We leaving. You think we gonna stay there?
Like, have it out. Like, what? I hope this is a lesson learned to them then, like, because like that's so dangerous to be like this is real life.
Yeah,
it's like y'all shooting at each other like live and direct. Like back in the day, like old school and stuff. Back in my day, at least they fight and then they shooting the air to clear the crowd and stuff.
Yeah,
but man, these boys are shooting at each other.
Whole brawls, really like about 10 versus 10, all that type of stuff going on. Nowadays they ain't even getting to that point. They scared.
At all.
They scared. So a lot of people ain't got beat up in their life before.
Doing the trial, like, did it bring back a lot of emotions and stuff like that?
Yeah, just seeing my baby, like, I just stopped seeing my baby feet. You feel me? And everybody had to see that picture. You know what I'm saying? Like,
so they showed the picture? Mm-hmm.
Everything.
They showed everything.
You was there, Shakira?
Shakira was there every day. Yeah. Don't play with my cousin.
Don't play. Shout out to Shakira.
None of my family.
Yeah.
Because they was there. They was
so how you time. Felt? How you felt today? It was like very emotional.
It felt like I was there. Like you hear the gunshots, you see Shia's feet, and the solicitor accidentally showed us a color picture of her laying there dead with the bullet in her head. Like it was an accident. Mm. And I literally felt like I was there. Like this whole week, I ain't even trying to get emotional. This whole week was like this every set, like to the end of the day, like I literally broke down the end of the day because it's been mentally draining the entire week last week. Like
I can only
you
imagine.
Know, like it make you like go home and just hug your kids. Like you don't know what may happen.
Yeah,
you know?
Anything.
Like you inside of your house and you can get killed on the inside of your house.
Inside your house, that one's
like you chilling, you living your everyday life, and you don't know who may come by your house and hit that shit.
Just like that. And like I said, your life can be changed like that.
And yeah, that's how I felt the whole week. Like it was draining. Like I took off. When Shell told me when the trial was gonna start that day, I went straight to my supervisor and said, I'm putting this in the system, I'm taking off for a whole week. The solicitor said, hey, we're going into probably next Tuesday or Wednesday. I text my supervisor, let her know. Mm-hmm. You know, this trial's still going on, and you know, I feel like I gotta be here.
Yeah.
Like my cousin let me know this for a reason. Like support. I gotta be here. And yeah, I took off. And yeah, when I got off, the night I supposed to get my child, I went and got my it got dropped off or even picked up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's real support though. And like I said, you need that. You need shot love, like showering the love when you're going through situations like this or whatever. So I had this question about Koi. Y'all both can answer this. Like, was it like the movies or whatever? Cause like I never really.
It made me interested in going into like, you know, moving from one profession to the next. Like, damn, maybe I need to get in crime scene like investigation. Just for it. Like, this is interesting. Yeah. Like, the stuff that they find, how they find it, how they detect it.
Like, first 48.
Yeah.
Man, you would think, like, you think you do a crime, you delete stuff, it's over.
It ain't going away.
It's there.
It don't go
the
away.
Person that started this. Call Ace phone 14 times. Mm-hmm. 14 times before it went down. Okay?
And send a text.
Okay.
Before it went down.
But the streets don't know this though. There you go. There y'all go. Y'all mowing it.
Got real
there y'all
fat.
Go. Like, come on. So how's it an accident? You knew what was going on. They got 48 bullets. 48 shell cases that they could count from the scene. Okay? Mm-hmm. So I don't know if they got to play in the 48.
But two left the scene.
You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. But we ain't gonna talk about this.
All right.
But you feel me? Like, it's a lot of stuff that came out to play. You feel me? Somebody called his phone 23 times. 23. Okay?
So that's cool. That's cool as hell. That is interesting, though, because, like, you just know
these
facts.
When they check the phone, all of this gone. All of this gone. Everything.
Nothing's really ever gone. No. Oh,
okay. No, nope. Especially on the iPhone.
Oh, okay.
So iPhones can be retrieved because that's through the internet. You send an iMessage.
iCloud. That's
the internet. So you can find that.
IP address.
iCloud.
Yeah.
Man, they was searching. They was searching my baby. And y'all want me to, how can I feel any kind of remorse? Like a real person, he turned himself in. How could you search my baby? You searched TASHYA J, base bird shooting. You search how to get gun residue off your hands. How to get gun residue out your hair. Mm. If somebody shoots at you and you shoot back and somebody die, what that
you
mean?
Do?
What do you do?
What do you do?
Look that up on Google. I'm telling you, Google know you more than you know yourself.
Oh, y'all, they looked that up.
That's scary.
5 o'clock in the morning, the same night my baby got killed that morning.
So they knew they had something to do with something.
Make it make sense, okay?
And Googling your daughter's name.
Googling it. But y'all want me to feel sorry. How? I ain't got too much to say about that man. I got some names I want to say.
You want justice for the old
I want them more.
Yeah.
I want them more.
Because they walk around like they shit don't
You walk stink. Around, y'all know y'all brought that. Y'all brought that down there. Y'all did.
Yeah.
Y'all brought that to Ace. Y'all did. But that's the only gun that was shot that could have penetrated that trailer that like it did. 7.62.
Mm.
That's the only one. My baby was killed with a 7.62.
Yeah, I looked it up.
And if it ain't a Draco, as I've been stating, it's in the Draco family. What's up?
It's one of them, like an AK-47 types or whatever. Like, a lot of them guns. I looked up. Like, it's like mm-hmm. Draco, the Uzi up in that family, mm-hmm. all that. So, I don't know, man. It's just pretty sad overall because, like, you know, it's just life. Like, it's like a movie, in my opinion. It's like, you made a decision. It happened to you. You just got to live with the consequences. And that's why when you're young or whatever, you want to go to your mama like, help me out, mama. But, hey, that's when you get over 18. It's on you.
Mm-hmm.
You better know that little young guy that's want to shoot these guns and just live your life the way you want to live.
You can make a decision in, like, 5 seconds that can affect the rest of your life. You definitely.
Because that's what happened.
Mm-hmm.
Like, honestly, that's what happened.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
because it's sad because we know both sides. Like, you hate the whole situation. The whole situation shouldn't have happened.
Yeah,
but unfortunately it did. And like, justice got to be served on one end because a life was taken on one end.
They said justice got to be served with me too because, you know, yeah, I was at the store and I took my kids down there, so I knew what was going to happen.
So they blaming you because people started shooting out there.
Yeah,
that's what they're trying to.
How you know, like, somebody gonna shoot bullets into a house and hit
exactly.
my daughter?
That's what I'm telling you. How I know you think I went to the store and I still passed by Hill Street and took my kids with me where I know it about to go down? Like, come on, y'all. Uh-huh. Y'all be making stuff, trying to make stuff sound so good. The truth has been proven. And that's why I want to come over here and pop my shit one more good time before I just shut up. I'm going to shut up until they get the other boys or something else gonna happen. Like, it ain't gonna be my karma, but karma is a bad bitch.
Oh yeah.
One of the person that was out there shooting, they had like 3 or 4 scrotes since my baby died.
That's what I'm saying.
And that come from a family member there.
Because they living with it. People know what they did and what was going on out there. They know they ain't have to do all that.
You know what I'm saying? Okay, then let me get on this part before I forget. Okay, cause like this karma, call my bad bitch. I ain't saying no.
Uh-huh.
Okay. The day my baby died that night. Okay. The night my baby died. You know, I was getting all kind of inboxes and stuff. Once they realized it's, you know, my baby, my Shia. I came up with TASHYA. I just spelled it with a Y. Okay. So basically, you know, me and Shia fell off. But anytime we see each other, we gonna talk. Ain't never no bad blood. You know what I'm saying? Somebody swing on. Hey, I'm gonna get them off. You know, that's just how I always felt about her. Like, I felt like that was my little sister. Okay, so when she finally went, everybody was feeling like it's Shell J baby Shia. She called me. She messaged me on Messenger. She was like, Shell, please tell me it's not Shia. Is she okay? And I was like, She dead. Then I said some more stuff to her. I was like, well, they said was out. You know, she was like, oh, no, he wasn't. She's sending me paragraphs. So she went and told the person that I said they said was out there. He sending me paragraphs. So, you know, I'm just like trying to get my mind right, trying to get all the stories together. Because at this point, like I told the police that night, I'm Shell J. I'll have you some information in the morning. Mm-hmm. Period. That night, people walked up to me telling me who it was. Come with me now. You about to walk up to the police right now. Yep. You feel what I'm saying? So that's how they did get the 2 witnesses they did got, because I made them girls walk with me to the police while you coming to tell me. Mm-hmm. You feel me? And I respect y'all. I love y'all girls. Thank
y'all. Shout out to y'all.
Yeah.
Whoever you are.
Yeah. Okay. But so she trying to explain herself all that, okay? She explained him. She said they was gone. They weren't even there. So the story ended up changing. They was there, but they was on the grind. Okay. The next morning, she hit me up. She was like, where you at? I'm like, I'm at my mama's house. So she was like, well, I'm going to come up there and talk to you. I'm like, okay. She came up to my house early that morning, about 10, 11 o'clock in the morning. My mama, my sister, my whole family, like everybody that's there early there. Even I think near light for all them sitting outside. Natosha ended up pulling up. But we all going in the house. All the other people standing out there. Me, my mom, my sister, and I think it was somebody else. Okay, so she come sat down. She was like, Shell. She started crying. I seen it. You know, telling me. So I'm like, okay. So I said, you to talk to the police? She said, yeah. Me and him went up there last night. Well, we went to back this morning, and I told him what I know. Oh, such and such gonna be mad at me because I told him what I know. I'm like, okay, man, I appreciate that, man. Thank you, you know. I'm cool with it. So I'm cool with the girl, you feel me? I'm cool with her, cool with her. Months go by. Next thing you know, we go to bond court. Her people in the bond court, you feel me? My people revoking her people bond. Ha! But y'all don't know that, though. Oh, okay. But he ain't never get charged, but they revoked his bond because they knew he was out there. Okay? So, the detective was like, who is that you talking to? I was like, that's... So the detective was like, who is that? And I was like, that's... I said, you should know who she is. She's like, I've been trying to get in touch with her. You know me. You been trying to get in touch with her. She left her number. She gave me the number. I'm like, that's the number I just talked to her for. She got that number. She was like, she won't answer. All right. Oh, so y'all ain't never talked to her? She said, no. They left their number at the police station saying that they wanted to talk. But when we called them and tried to get in contact, because the address they got is her old address. So when they tried to get in contact with her, they never could get in contact with her. Okay, I'm gonna beat your motherfucking ass. Okay, at the end of the day, you know what I'm saying? Like, people think, oh, she just trying to be a bully. She trying to make that girl say something. I'm not trying to make that girl say nothing. How do you feel like it was okay before I even put my baby in the ground to come up to my mama house? I didn't ask you to come. So it's just like, it's a whole other ball game when I say I'm going to whoop you. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm going to talk to you while I'm talking whooping you. Because you should have knew how to play that shit. How did you feel like it was okay to come up there while I'm grieving? I'm still in shock mode. Mm-hmm. I couldn't even cry for my baby for like a whole 5 days. Because I'm still shocked like, this what shit ain't true.
Yeah,
it you know what happen. I'm saying? And you feel like it was okay to come up there and tell me all of this. I didn't ask you to tell me you seen who was shooting. You told me that. You know what I'm saying? So now, when I want to react on it, I'm the bad guy. Oh, Shell J need to just accept that her baby gone. I done accepted it. But, and you got to accept that I'm going to whoop your ass. Because at the end of the day, it's just certain shit you don't do. Facebook. So I grew up with her. I grew up with this girl. I went to school with the girl in Rich Brain. I didn't even know the girl was there. The girl came to my house before I buried my baby, to my mama's house. With a candle. This is how she talk. Shell, I'm so sorry. Shell. She make candles now. She coming there with a candle. My baby name on. I'm like, hold on, wait a minute. You was out there? She like, yes, yes. I said, so why you talk to the police? I'ma talk to him. I'ma talk to him. I just don't, them two people. How do y'all feel like it was okay to come up to my mama house? If you didn't want to be involved, okay, I can't be mad about that.
Yeah, but
when you come to my mama house telling me this, telling me that, how could you feel like that's okay? And I'm not supposed to be mad. I'm not supposed to react.
Yeah, I feel like that's a little fake in a opinion. Don't say nothing. If exactly. You ain't going to do nothing, don't say
don't
nothing.
Be
don't
even
say,
all
you know,
together.
I would just stay out the way. In my opinion, that's how I feel like it should be. Don't be up in my face saying you're going to do this and do this for me when I'm in this time going on, this situation going on. Next thing you know, you ain't even did it for
fake
me.
Love,
like, I'll be real hurt if I feel like I grew up with you. Then you come to me and say you talk to these people to on my behalf to help me out. Mm-hmm. Especially, like I said, we from the same time. Like I say, you a mother just like me. So, like, you know, well, you're a woman or whatever. So, it's like, and then I come to find out you didn't say anything. I have to look at you different. And I understand a lot of people in the town, you look at them different now.
Yeah. I look at a lot of people differently, but I don't blame, like, one of the boys involved. I'm still going to speak to his mama every time I see him. Because, baby, I know what you raised. You know what I'm saying? But it's also one boy involved. His mama uphold everything he do. Don't speak to me, baby. Don't speak to me. You know what I'm saying? But this other boy involved, I'm going to speak to his mama. I'm going to speak to his mama every time I see him. Because at the end of the day, yo, these boys was grown. Or they wanted to be grown. Mm-hmm. So they got to live with what they did. I don't blame everybody that's affiliated with these people. Unless you give me reason to act like that. Like, I got a boy at work. Stare at me. Wear a little black flag and stuff. You feel me? This man stare at me every day. What's up, buddy? Nah. What's up, buddy? You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what I want to know. Why? Why? And when y'all watch this, I want to know why. How y'all feel like y'all are so mad at me? My baby was innocent. And I ain't got to keep saying it because it's been proven.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's why I wanted to come over here and speak my mind, say what I got to say one last time. You get what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, ain't nothing I can change. I just got to keep moving. Mm-hmm. I got to get out of Batesburg. I'm from Rich Brian. So I guess that's why they treat me like an outsider. Because RSM... Hey, but yeah, I'm sorry.
You gotta throw these bowls in. But like I said, I want to say this though. Like I said, Bitwo was saying earlier, like when you hit him up on the DM saying you want to come on, it's like, man, this is exactly what we made this stuff for in our head. For like when our hometown having something going on, like we get the sword straight from the horse, you know. Like nobody can't say what Shell J said. Nobody can't say what happened. Like you was in the court, you heard the fact.
And that's what I'm saying. How could anybody say anything from yesterday? Because before yesterday, we went to bond court 4 times. Nobody else could come in the courtroom but me, my mama, my sister, Bug. Like nobody else could come in the courtroom to hear these facts. So when y'all come hear these facts, y'all still got so much to say. Mm-hmm. At the end of the day, you are grown. If I go out here and kill somebody the motherfucking day, baby, I'm grown. I gotta be held accountable for my actions.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? It's accountability. You gotta be accountable for what mm-hmm. you do. You know what I'm saying? Like when I run my mouth, Shell, if you wanna run your mouth, that might would not happen. I gotta take accountability for that.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Like, Shell, shut the fuck up. Be quiet. Hush.
Mm-hmm.
You know? But at the end of the day, that's a whole other ball game with a murder.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Whole different
story.
My
baby was 11. You know, my baby was trying to protect herself. Just imagine how my baby
just scared. Just scared. You know, he gunshot.
How my baby heart was beating, trying to hide beside that refrigerator because she heard him shot.
Yeah, don't even know what's going on. Just hide.
And I never taught my baby. I never taught neither one of my kids, oh, you hear shots hit the grind. But yeah, I'm screaming hit the grind. So, I'm telling her, don't move. Don't move, Shia. Don't move, Maya. That's what I'm screaming the whole fucking time. Because my homegirl over here just, I'm just screaming. Yeah. Screaming.
And so shock, but they showed the video sometimes.
Didn't they show the video at trial? Huh? Oh, when they were shooting outside. Didn't they show the video at trial?
Yeah. They didn't show the actual shooting. They just showed like a ring camera that caught every shot.
Mm. Oh, just the sound of the gunshot.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So, yeah, they showed that, and it's just like, you had to relive that stuff again because we know who shot first. You can hear him on the camera.
So you hear people's voices.
Your big, nasty, ugly, stanky self. Okay. But yeah. Yeah, if you know, you know. You know what I'm talking about. Okay.
I don't know, though, but I want to know.
Yeah, but
we'll learn after the podcast.
Basically, he shot first, okay? Well, we know who brought him down there, right?
He didn't shoot at nobody, though, clearly. Though.
No, he didn't shoot at anybody. He shot in the air.
So he brought himself, Shell.
Huh?
He brought himself.
Oh, yeah.
He brought himself.
Yeah, he brought himself.
So, they talked about him in the courtroom.
Oh, yeah. They called everybody
names,
baby.
Every name.
Listen, I ain't got to wonder who was involved.
What?
These people know.
Listen to Connie know these what these people
know. So, if they know,
everything
I wonder why they haven't picked them up.
Everything because we heard in the
like,
courtroom.
Yeah.
What?
It's basically like hearsay.
Hearsay. That's the problem also. You just hear about it. Yeah.
It's basically like they know it's true. But also, do they got that proof to prove?
Yeah,
the facts.
You know what I'm saying? They had the proof to prove a shot that gun in with his own testament. He stood up. He got on the stand. Yeah, I shot till I empty. My clip was empty. Okay? Shot till his clip was empty.
And he said, what gun he shot?
The trailer we was in 8 times.
Whoa.
Mm. So how many bullets come in the clip?
30, but he only had 15.
Okay.
He only had
15
heels.
Mm. Dang. Oh my God. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, that's crazy.
That 15 that they found.
That they found out there.
Right there. Oh, yeah.
That's what I'm saying. Like, he said, I read somewhere in one of the newspaper articles that he said he was shooting to kill. And that's what you did, no matter who it was. You maybe wasn't shooting at that person, but you took an innocent life away. So, that's why I keep wanting to pound the people's head. You just got to deal with the consequences of doing that. Like, you put yourself in a position where you let someone else be in control of your life and how much time you got to spend in the situation. And they gave your years because white people, they don't care about your life. There's another black man in the system, throw him in there. And like I said, but you put yourself in that situation to get judged by them. So,
and that's the thing. All us lost. Ain't
nobody
winning.
Nobody
wanted this situation. It's the pussy ass niggas that still walking around. Yeah. Excuse my language. I try to be respectful, y'all.
What
do
you think?
But
fuck that.
Like, that's the only people winning because these niggas still get to walk around, do what they want to do, and still cause more hell because one of the person involved was just involved in something else again. You get what I'm saying? So it's like you still causing problems everywhere you go.
More have it.
You know what I'm saying? So it's just like I hate the fact that they're not locked up, but I'm not. I didn't see nobody. I seen the cars I seen when I came out the door once my baby was shot. Y'all ain't move quick enough, baby, because I wanted y'all to kill me. That's how I felt when I seen my baby was killed. I'm out the door. I see the cars leaving. You know what I'm saying?
So after that situation happened, it happened so fast, so you walk outside and like...
Like, once we realized, once he ran in the house, and I guess Bull started looking around. You feel me? When Bull looked around, she seen my baby feet, and she pointed. I mean, she was like, Shell, she just kept saying my name. I'm like, what, bro? And so when I look over at her, she just doing like this. So when I get up, when I look, I see my baby feet. I got up off the floor. I had this same little motherfucking pocketbook off by the slide. I don't know why. I kicked my shoes off, took my pocketbook off. Walked up to her. I swear to God on my life, bullets were still going. I could hear, it sounded like me like, shh, shh, shh. Like, that's what I was hearing when I hit them motherfucking bullet. Like, they was coming through that house.
So, it's still going.
They was still going. I grabbed my baby. I'm like, Shia. When I grabbed it, that's when I seen the hole. I dropped on the floor. When I dropped on the floor and the bullet started rolling out, I ran to the door. I'm like, boy, get my baby. Boy, get my baby. She's like, Shia, don't go out there. They still shooting. When I opened the door, I heard, like, one or two more shots. When I opened up the screen, though, I seen the cars. Like, I heard them cranking up and seen them speeding up the road. So, I'm running out the door at this point, but it's so fucking, like,
chaotic.
Dusty. It's so dusty. So, the only thing you see is dust for the cars just speeding out of there, speeding out of there. So, my first mind, I hadn't seen on Snap. It was a party at Talika House.
Yep.
I start heading towards Talika's house. Tamikio got on the stand and testified that she said she seen me walking towards that house. I never seen her though. Because once I seen my baby was hit, I just knew my baby was dead. My baby felt like a feather. She just felt lifeless when I grabbed her. So I just ran out the door and I'm like, hey, y'all done killed my baby. I'm just screaming, y'all done killed my baby. So they're like, who is that? People start coming out the door like, who is that? Who is that? I'm like, this Shell Jay, this Shell Jay. Before I can get to Talika's house, I'm right at her driveway. Everybody surrounded me. And I just dropped down. I'm like, call the ambulance, call my mama. Just like, y'all, they done killed my baby, they done killed my baby. So everybody left me and tore out towards Borg House. I wish I would have did that differently. Like, a lot of people got to walk in there and see her on that floor dead. Like, it was, the story was out there. This person had blood on them because they moved her. So I asked him, did he move my baby? Because why? You already seen the blood coming from my head. You should have never touched her. He was like, he tried to do CPR. He was just trying to find a pulse. But Jasmine Jenny's mama, Shamika Jenny, thank you, I love you. She was the first person on scene. And she was in there trying to do CPR on my baby because she is, like, certified. Yeah. Mm-hmm. But I was out of doubt why all of this happened. But a lot of people left me and ran to see my baby and they on that fucking grind. And a lot of people seen her. And that's why, like, when they play the 911 call, you can hear Bull screaming, telling people, get the fuck out, get the fuck out. Because when she came back to her senses, she like, they come here and see this dead baby. Like, y'all gotta get out, get the fuck out. Yeah. And she seen the other person that you're gonna get got. Yeah. Mm-hmm. He came in there and looked at my baby.
What that?
You know what I'm saying? And I know it ain't a lot because his daddy already had told me after it happened. He said, my son was in the woods. I heard you screaming, y'all done killed my baby. Because he called my phone.
That's so sad.
You feel me? So it's just like, it's more verification. Like, they already know. I ain't even have to tell the people your name because they know. They know. You know what I'm saying? Mm. They know who it started with at the Manetta store. They know who brought who to Rocket Lane. They know who was already dying there in Rocket Lane. You get what I'm saying? These people know everything, but ain't nobody talking. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. See, there we go again. Let me pull the cord along. There you go. You good now. It's been. But I don't want to say that. But in my opinion, that's what people, you see. Why? Why would she be mad about any scenes with the stuff she had to witness that night? The story she just telling, like, that sounds like a movie to me. Like, just people seeing that and that going on. Yeah, you see people running up in Bull House going.
I ain't even never heard it about
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I ain't never knew none of that stuff.
Everybody ran in there and looked at my baby. Like, some people, I think Yaya had said she did touch her, or like she turned her over to see, or something, because somebody took her phone out of her hand. Because she was had her phone in her hand when she went down. So somebody took it out and put it on the counter. You know, so I don't know who did that.
Because who was the Shai phone at?
Took her phone out of her hand.
Her phone was in her hand when
she came out of the room, because she was in the room on Bud Big on her phone.
Yeah.
So when she heard shots and heard me screaming, she must have just ran out the room. Shy being shy, she couldn't just get on that grind. She had to come see what was going on. So that's what my baby did. She had to come see what was going on. So when she seen we was on that floor, that's when she, instead of hitting the floor like us, she just started trying to duck beside the refrigerator. And then that's this big old hole right there by the refrigerator. Like, the refrigerator probably this high and the hole probably right there.
So you said it went through the refrigerator.
Went through the back of it. It came through like the back of the house. Then the shit, so CSI, they had a screen. They tied one end to one end. You can see where that bullet went all the way through. Mm. It came through the back of Bug House, went through her back wall right there in front of her refrigerator, went in the back of her refrigerator, and did like a ricochet and come out the side of it. Mm. Came out the side of it.
And what these people can find and create and just show the story. They can tell the story. Exactly what we're trying to do on this thing. Mm-hmm. And like I say, I always think too, like, has this situation made you closer to your mama? Like, your daughter, your family? You know what I'm saying?
I would say to certain people, because, like, somebody in my family, when we got to arguing, they told me, tell Shai to get up. Oh, she can't. Her mama the reason she dead. You know what I'm saying?
What?
So it's like they sent me coffins and... You know what I'm saying? And it's a immediate family member. You know
what? I got my heart beating fast.
Yeah, so
that's,
you know,
that's disgusting.
And definitely it's like, I had to forgive that person though, because I had so much hate in my heart. Like,
whoa.
And it's still, I ain't gonna say it's not there, because it is. Like, she apologized, but it's still, it don't take away what you said, what you
definitely
meant.
Don't.
You know what I'm saying? And I already blamed myself. She was one of the people that I cried to. You know what I'm saying? To let her know, like, man, the way they took my baby, why I ain't stay home? You know, I'm crying to her. Let her know exactly how I feel, and don't too many people see that, you know? And she used that against me. So that just made me more, like, I could say distant. Like, I don't really want to go to the family gatherings. I'm good. Yeah, come pick my baby up. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, like, I can understand.
My mama, I tell my mama every day.
Y'all pick off. But you need family, though, because like family gonna lift you up when you're down, man. Because these are the people that know you from the time you was born to now. Like, they just look at you as the person you are instead of how everybody look at you out of exterior or whatever. Mm-hmm. People just see the inside of your family. That's why I love real with you. They just didn't. Just being 4th of July and then the day before that with my grandma having a little birthday get together. It's like just seeing how my family just uplifts me in my head.
It gives you a different energy.
These people that really know me and love me. So I would say, you need to, you know, build a relationship.
Have you felt like you got that good energy back inside you? Like, I know since all the tragedy and stuff, have you got that, like, a good light, you know?
I mean, I'm still Shell Jay. If you know me, you know me. Oh, yeah. Like, you know, some gonna hate me, some gonna love me, you know? And I'm just a vibe. Anyway, I go, I'm gonna pick you up. Like, hey, girl, let's go. Like, girl, you know? So I've been trying to do that, you know, mm-hmm. not always walking around so sad. Mm-hmm. Even though, you know, I'm feeling like this, let me try to see who I can pick up. Because everybody ain't strong like me. Everybody ain't built like me.
Yeah.
Like, this woman I know from, like I said, my baby cousin, her mama in a whole nursing home. You feel me? For her baby, she losing her baby, she come bounce back from that. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So I look at that like, it's a lot of people ain't where I'm at. Like, I'm in like a lot of grief groups. Like, I done met a lot of people over the time. You feel me? So when I go meet them people, just listen to them people older than me. And they ain't even where I'm at. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So it's like, I look at it like, shit, you got to use it. Like, something keeping you here, something keeping you going. Because I ain't going to say ain't been times I want to kill myself. Because it has. You know what I'm saying? I ain't going to say, and I ain't going to mean like stab or shoot. I mean like take an overdose. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
or
just don't wake
like
up.
That. Yeah, you know, I ain't going to say I ain't never thought about that. Let me go put this truck in the tree. You know, but I have. But then again, that shit outweighs like, how kids going to feel?
Exactly. Like,
you know, mm-hmm. she already lost her sister. So how she going to feel? You know? But I had to get back to the point to where like, Shell, you got to raise kids. You know, you ain't failed your daughter, but that's also too. I feel like I failed her. But at the end of the day, I know I did.
Life is still going. Like, you acting like, you know, you still here, you still doing.
It's different, though. Like, it's a lot different.
I know it's a lot different.
You know, once you're so used to something, it's just like, it's hard to break out that routine, you know?
Used to having both your kids there.
Yeah, like, I ain't want to get up and go fix a sandwich. My fat ass want to sit on a chair. Shawty, go fit my sandwich. Shawty, go fit my sandwich. Shy, go do your edges.
Go get the remote.
You feel me? Shy, I'm shy. I'm about to go somewhere. I'll be back. Okay, mom, I'm gonna lock the door. And by the time you come back, it's gonna be clean. I walk back in there, everything clean. Don't play with my girl. Up. You know what I'm saying? So, but it's just like I know.
Small things.
I look at that like, Shell, no matter what nobody say about you, you knew what you was to your kids, and you knew your kids loved you where they love you. You know what I'm saying? So. You know, I just feel like she felt like mama should have saved her. So they just feel like that would fuck me a little bit.
But mama,
people say they see their kids stuff. I haven't seen her. Like, you know, they say they come to them.
Yeah. Not at all. You feel like you had no conversation with her.
I don't know. I don't want to. And to a certain extent, like, I don't go to her grave. The last time I've been to her grave was June the 9th when the 1 year came up. And before that, I only went in September because of her birthday.
Yeah.
But it's just like, it's hard to accept it. But yes. I wake up every day like, yeah, shit, Shy gone. You know, I only sleep in my bed because my mama put a picture on my damn mirror of her. So it's just like, I ain't going to say I try to block it out, but I do.
But yeah. It feel like how, blocking it out, I feel like that's the way you cope with it, right?
Yeah.
And like, you haven't talked to anyone one-on-one yet, have you?
Well, I did talk to Miss Brittany Dorn, hey, if you see this, because she reached out to me because she seen my last podcast. And she offered me classes pro bono.
Yeah,
whatever that means, yeah. Okay, but yeah, she offered me classes, so I did go meet with her, but... She's a great person. She got a good spirit. The place is pretty. It make you just want to sit back and relax. But once I did it and left, it was just like, I couldn't make myself go back because I just felt like I wasn't ready for it.
No.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't mind voicing my opinion, but I just don't want to write it down or... I don't know.
Sometimes, I guess, you might not be ready for it, but sometimes you need it to get it off of you.
Or sometimes to be uncomfortable.
Yeah, not talk to somebody that you talk to on a regular day basis. Just talk to somebody that don't really even know what you got going on so they can give you just the unbiased feedback.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because, like, that's what you need because, like, you got this, because you so angry inside, like, and you can't even control it. It's like, you just angry because, like, they took your daughter away. You should be angry.
She has no reason not to be.
Yeah, but you got to figure a way to fuel that anger into something positive because, like, life is still moving. Like, you still got kids and you still could be the great Shell Jay. Like you said, use your power as your voice for something positive. You know, mm-hmm. and not for something, nigga. Cause like you yeah. way bigger than that. Like that's why you still here, and that's why that okay. You, the shy situation happened, it kind of slowed you down because you have a different perspective on life. But now you know how to use that anger for fuel. Mm-hmm. That's how I feel like you gotta just that figure that out. What you like to do? Yeah. What you like to do? What makes you happy? Besides, I gotta see your Snapchat. What you saying? What you saying to your Snap? You say your Snapchat. People be having.
I don't follow shit on Snap.
That one side I just had to follow outside.
Yeah, y'all better find me. Long live Shia forever with two A's.
Uh-huh. It's great like that. But they said.
Yeah, everybody, you got to have a wristband to get in here, baby. Everybody can't get in there. Everybody can't get in there. No, but yeah.
You got to have a wristband.
Yeah.
VIP to get
VIP?
In there.
VIP?
VIP. Everybody can't get in there.
Yeah. So you saying you enjoy just talking to the people?
Not really. I mean, I enjoy, like, you know what I, y'all know what I enjoy. Y'all see
Oh, yeah.
That's like my biggest cope, like honestly, okay. like that's what I'm trying to get. Like I ain't gonna say I'm trying to get off it because I like it, I love it. I'm not trying to quit it.
Yeah.
It really helps me. Like other people might say, no, it don't. That's a mind thing, baby. I could be boohoo crying. I hit that much.
I don't know.
I'm Shell Jay. If that makes you feel that way, why would you even think about getting off of it?
Cause it's just like people around me, like my mom, like that's a big thing. She want me to get off. You know,
but
like,
you gotta understand your mom her was mindset. Different time of life. Like,
yeah,
she just it's like nothing wrong. Like I always tell people, like my whole life, I thought my mama and my mama and my daddy because I that's what you thought. But my mama is my superhero, and she still is my superhero. But superheroes do have quote unquote flaws. They're not perfect. They still growing. They still learning.
Yep.
You know, like.
And that's what I have to tell a girl. Go on now. Go on, sit down somewhere.
Sometimes your way ain't the right way. Yeah. Just because my mama don't mean that you smarter than me in this area. Yeah. But you are wiser than me, and I'm definitely gonna listen to what you got to say.
Oh, yeah.
But,
I'm gonna take it into consideration. You know.
Yeah. Exactly.
Before I make my decision. I'd be like, well, how my mama gonna feel? Yeah, but then I'd be like, man, fuck
that,
I'm grown.
Like I say, just do everything that's gonna make you happy when like you wake up in the morning. Cause we were talking to Trey, and he say some days he wake up. That's Trey from he and Jay right now. Also,
he made a song for my baby. Then you heard about Jamaya and Shia?
I didn't hear that song.
That
junk,
you gonna have to play that junk on here. That junk.
Oh man, I wish I'd have heard it.
It got mad. He like, I see you ride with me. He tells Jamaya, I see you ride with your dad and stuff.
Yeah,
he made a little song.
Oh, that's so cool. But he said he rolled out of bed, and some day he rolled out of bed and just think. Like he still out and whatever. Then he opened his eyes, look at the white wall or whatever. And like, I know sometimes you wake up and you like you can talk to Shia or whatever. But like, what's one thing you would say to her if you? I know you say I love you, but like, what would you say?
I'm sorry. Like that's what I say every day. You know what I'm saying? Like I just like I'm sorry. I just look up or something like I'm sorry, Shia. If I see a picture, I'm sorry, Shia. Like everything that I had, like memorial stuff, is at my mama house. Mm-hmm. You'll come in there, you can might see one picture of Shia. You go in Kira's room, she got a whole Shia wall. But my house, you don't see Shia. You know what I'm saying? So, like I said, my bedroom is a picture of her. My mom put it on my mirror. I don't sleep in my bed. I haven't slept in my bed in over a year. Mm-hmm. I'm going to sleep in there when it's...
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But, yeah, I don't sleep in my bed.
Yeah.
I don't sleep in my bed, though. I don't.
I know we September 17th, we got to Shia there.
Yeah, that's coming soon. Second annual, okay? We trying to get it together still. But last year, we did it real, like, what's the word I'm looking for? We was late, basically. Mm-hmm. But it still turned out good, and it was a big day, and the kids looked like they ready for it. Like, I done had a couple kids ask me, what y'all doing for Shia's birthday? Y'all doing something for Shia's birthday? So I'm going to use that, like, on her birthday every year and do something fun with the kids.
I think you got to do that. Keep her name alive.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Like I say, Shakira told us about it, and said we did. Twin shots need to be in the building, so I'll definitely be there.
Yeah.
Well, like, we do every year Labor Day weekend, we have a Mama Day, Mama B Day. This is my grandma's mother. And we do that every year where we just celebrate. It's like a celebration with a family, but we call it Mama B Day. Like I say, hi to Shia Day. And like, we do that every year. Like, you just keep your family name alive.
Yeah, we said that last year. Like when we did it, we knew that it was going to be an every year thing. It's not something that's gonna stop, and it's not to just celebrate Shia's birthday, but it's like to bring awareness, like, you know, we gotta put a stop to this. Like, this Shia was killed by gun violence, like, you know, she wasn't in no gang, she wasn't, you know, a part of none of what was going on outside. So, you know, just to bring awareness, like we had already said, like, you know, we're gonna, you know, it's gonna be fun for the kids. Mm-hmm. It's gonna be fun for the kids. But it's also going to be, you know, informational for the kids, you know, like, because we're a small town and this situation itself has, like, literally torn apart the city. Like, you know how when somebody die, like somebody granddaddy died, granddaddy know everybody. Oh, y'all done fucked the city up with this one.
Yeah.
Nah, this one right here really fucked the city up.
So divided.
Like, everybody, like,
and it's crazy. It's not even divided, in a good way.
But you family. Yeah. You family and you divided. Yeah. And that's this crazy thing. Like, you know, you got one person on this side that, you know, some person, and the other person on this side, they actually fuck with each other. Like, they love each other. They got real serious love for each other. But he on this side with this person, you on this side with this person.
Yep.
Like, it felt like that. It felt like, dang, I can't even talk to you right now while we in
this trial. Like politics, yeah. Right?
Like, we can't, kinda, I can't yeah. even talk to you. Like,
it's like blood crip, but it's like,
should, yeah, it like, shouldn't I even can't be even like talk that. To you because right now I'm supporting Shia.
Yeah.
Right now I'm standing up for Shia.
You supporting justice.
Yeah. Yeah, like, you know, and I still feel like, you know, I'm not going to lie. I don't, yeah, when you do something, you deserve consequences.
Oh, yeah.
But he's not the only person. He's yeah. not the only person. And for that reason, my heart broke for him. Your own family treat you off the streets.
Mm. No.
Your own family. So, I feel like the only way to stop this is to start with this little town.
Yeah.
Start with this little town. And it starts with Shia Day. I hate that it took this, yeah. but we can make it fun.
Mm-hmm.
We can make it fun. We can turn it up a little bit, yeah. and that's how I feel right now, you know. And I hate this stuff that's going on right now. I hate the things that's being said on social media about my cousin. I hate, you know, I hate the lies that's being told.
No.
But I can't change nothing. When as soon as you get on Facebook, before you even post a status, say what's on your mind. You yep. posting what's on your mind.
Yeah.
Like, you can't change what's on somebody else's mind.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
what I wish that you would do was just shut up and talk about it amongst yourself, because yeah. what you're saying, you weren't there and you weren't in court for them 7 long days. If you would have been there, I promise you would have felt like you was at that scene.
Had a different perspective. Yeah. They're not educated on the situation.
Yeah.
That's because so in a way, want attention.
You know, you're going by hearsay. What was said out here in these streets, and it wouldn't hold up in court.
Yeah,
like,
and what
every
really
time,
happened,
every time hearsay came by somebody about, Your Honor, I object. Your Honor, I object, because it's hearsay. So that shouldn't stand in the streets either. And
if
that's
think,
how I feel.
Everybody know Theo. You think Theo wanna, well, why Miss J at the store? Theo ain't even bringing it out of his mind, because he knew it was bullshit.
Yeah.
So y'all need to just, like, that's how I feel. Just get off of that. Like, I ain't gonna tell y'all how to feel. I can't tell y'all not to be there for y'all family. You're supposed to. I'm not mad about none of that. Just don't post nothing about my daughter or be disrespectful. That's all I'm asking, because we can really take it there. We can really get active about mine. Like, that's just that on that, you know? It ain't my fault. All these niggas are guilty. All these dudes, I'm start saying niggas. All these dudes are guilty.
Niggas. They
all
niggas.
All of them got their time. All of them got their time. It's not in my hands. And every time every one of them go to court, they're going to say, damn, I Shell Jay had to come in there. So did.
I was there.
In the number.
Because at the end of the day, right is right and wrong is wrong. So,
and
I
then
mean,
the second person that was charged for her, when he go to court, I'm going to be in there.
Yeah.
I'm going
to
be in there.
So you talk to the investigators or whatever, they're saying they close to getting other people off the street?
Not really. It's just like I say, ain't nobody still want to talk. And then it's to the point of, like, we don't want to hear nothing. You got to say a whole year later anyway. You know what I'm saying?
Really,
so
though.
It just proof. Like, once them y'all, if y'all still got them, whatever, and the shit come up or something like that, that is proof. You get what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
It's basically, you got to prove this shit. It ain't what you know is shit.
Yeah, what you can prove.
Yeah. So once they can prove it, it's a whole nother ball game. You get what I'm saying? But I just feel like it's a fucked up situation, because no, Ace was not shooting by himself. You feel me? But at the end of the day, Ace had time to think. Ace had time to tell his cousin, no, bro, no, get the fuck on. Yeah. Bro, when that bro called your phone 14 times, you had time to tell that man, don't bring that shit down here. You could have got in your car and left if you didn't want nothing to do with it. You made that decision. Yeah. You made that decision. You never felt that threatened, because the shooting started at like 7. The first person that shot was on like 7. Okay? And them facts. You get what I'm saying? So it's just like, it's bar none. And I ain't gonna speak on it no more. It is what it is. My baby man ain't gonna never come back. And he the first person that got his time. Mm. But it's 6 or 7 more. It's coming.
Okay. Mm.
So
you would want everybody to get 48 years?
I want them motherfuckers getting more. Fuck you talking. I want all of them getting more. Especially the mastermind.
Yeah.
because it's just the point. I grew up with you. I done saved you so many times.
So he talked about the mastermind at trial?
They ain't call him no mastermind, but his name was called so many times, baby. Why he ain't in here?
Yeah.
Even still, why he ain't in here? We need to know why he ain't in here.
Names was being called. Boy, so
nickname.
Y'all got a whole story.
They know everybody, Elias.
Boys on the A.
Yeah.
Y'all think
everybody.
AKAs and all.
Okay.
Every, when I tell you, they know it all, they know it all.
Just know, they know it, y'all. And like I say, you better know next time. Like I say, Cormac is a mother trucker. So just know, yo, it's coming to you.
Breathing
you know,
down that neck.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Somebody breathing down that neck.
Being positive, man.
Next time you feel, that cold shiver go down your spine.
Hey,
coming from behind.
Fucking throw your back.
I'm just so happy that Shell came here to have a conversation with us because I know a lot of people got so much thing to say, but when we drop this thing, they gonna hear whatever Shell got to say.
Oh, yeah. They gonna be beat mad, but it's okay. It's okay because it ain't nothing but facts. I just spoke. What I want to tell y'all, y'all think I want it, Ace to be my baby killer? Like, that's how I read the stats that I read. Like, y'all think I wanted that. Yeah. I didn't tell that man to pull out that big ass gun and shoot it.
Nope.
He had three different ones he could choose from. Three. And he chose that one. So
you even know he had three of them?
Oh, all that was in the court. He said it on the stand. He got on the stand and said it. You get what I'm saying? Three of them.
Did you get on the stand?
No, they won't let me.
Oh.
I got up there and talked because I heard the boy said that on his snap. Something like, y'all know y'all could have got up there and talked for that man. What?
Talk for my daughter? Like, talk against my daughter? Like, that what it sound like.
I just ain't understand that part. Like, huh? What I supposed to say? I ain't get up there and say, oh, he's such a bad, bad guy. I know Quayshawn. That's all I can say.
I'm bad.
I know Ace, so that's all I can say. Like, I ain't got nothing bad to say about that man, but that man, my baby killer.
Yeah.
That's the bottom line.
That's a crazy line, though, because, like, I ain't got nothing bad to say about him, but he is my baby killer.
He my baby killer. Like, other people that's involved, the mastermind, I can say plenty of bad shit about this man. Like, I could go days and days and days about this man.
That's like a key saying, and, like, unnecessary gun violence, though. Like, I ain't got nothing bad to say, but he my baby killer. Because
mm-hmm.
at the end of the day, that's the sad truth about, like, guns. Like, the guns are situations like that. Like, you may not mean to do it. You may not mean to hurt anybody else other than who you, you know, got into it with or whatever, but...
He's screenshotting over here.
It unfortunately happened, so...
Yeah.
I think everybody can say they hate it was Ace. Because he's such a, like, you know, he's
likable guy, you know.
Yeah, he's genuine. Everybody, like, I did the community trash pickup with them guys last year, the year before that.
Yeah.
Because we did there. It since 2020 or whatever. But, like, it was a good time. Like, it was the two times I did it with this man, he came out both times. And he never gave bad vibes. Mm-hmm. Anytime I was around this man, he never gave bad vibes. So I hate that it was him because his heart is just so big. And I know he sincerely meant his I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I know he sincerely meant that to Shell.
Yeah. But that's still, like I say, don't change the fact of what happened.
It don't change the facts. It don't change the fact. It doesn't change his admission. It doesn't change anything. But I think we all can say that we hate it was him.
Yeah. But it make me feel like a little bit like, okay, because, you know, I'm thinking Ace feeling like how everybody on these streets, his people that, you know, he was running with, how they posted status is feeling. I'm thinking Ace feeling like that. But just to hear him talking in that courtroom, like, I just, like, I ain't, like, fuck everybody else, but...
He had a lot of time to think about it, too, though.
Yeah.
And, like, he know the decision when he put himself in, he done had, like I said, a lot of time to think about it, and, like, he just got to deal with the consequences.
Nobody could have spent 48 years, though.
He even admitted to, you know, him having to deal with it himself because, you know, I killed this child, mm-hmm. and I got two kids of my own out here. That, you know, I ain't gonna never really get to experience their prom or their graduation or their successes because of the decision that I made trying to take up for my family.
Exactly.
Trying to be there and protect my family, not knowing that my bullet was gonna hit another child. He has a child around the same age as Shell. So, I mean, everybody knows that he's not that type of person. Nobody is on social media at this point bashing him.
Yeah.
But it's a start of justice. And that's what we and that's what we're excited about. That's all we're excited about. It's the start of justice.
Cause let them tell it, oh, it wasn't gonna be no justice. She don't know who killed her baby. She don't know this. I ain't never even spoke. I been knew that that man, his bullet was one that killed my baby. I found out when I went to the second bond court. But I never got on social media saying this, or this. No, I never did because I want other people too.
Yeah.
Yeah, I want Ace because Ace shot his gun, his bullet, you know what I'm saying? But I want other people more, I feel. You know what I'm saying? That's just how
you I guess you probably feel that way because he already getting his consequence.
Right,
Like the other ones, they out here getting to just live just like
freely right now at this moment in time.
And it's hard to try to stay sane when you see them people. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. I know my baby daddy ain't no stepper, but I know what I am. You
definitely more controllable than me. I couldn't. Yeah, ain't no way in hell I sit here and see you. Every time I see you,
Men, no. One of them a big nasty nigga.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like you though. Like, you feel me? Yeah.
I got my nigga beater though.
Okay, then.
My nigga beater. I listen to Shakira talk, like, man, I just picture Shakira just sitting on the stage, like, you know, her and Brad, like, you having some politician situations in the town of Batesburg, man. I feel like y'all could really, because Brad, this man be on the phone talking to everybody, so he's so connected, but he don't want to be on the scene. He don't want to have a
behind,
he don't want to talk.
Now my brother not like that.
With Shakira talking though, I feel like, you know, it's a movement could be had. It could be made.
Yeah.
I don't know about all that.
Yeah, something could happen.
How she was breaking it down when y'all were inside. Where it was like, I could just listen to it, you know?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I mean, just a word of thought in my head.
And I guess maybe that's because I was so in tune to it. Like, I was really into this trial, and it was very interesting for one. It's like, it's a lot of shock. Like, it just hit you with stuff. Like, what? I ain't heard that.
I know these people too. I know.
Hey, when they say it, they be like, we hit each other. Like, what the fuck? We can't make
They
be on kick y'all ass out of there.
Contempt.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, this is my shell. You know, I ain't know that. They ain't tell me that. They do not tell me that. Yeah. So it was real raw. It was real raw and uncut, you know. But I'm glad it's over with.
Glad it is still a sad situation, but I can say glad it's over with. Like I said, you got justice, sort of, kind of, you know,
because it ain't really never gonna be justice.
It never is, and that's the sad truth about it. Like these, like that gun stuff supposed to be. Like, I mean, self defense, yada yada yada. But I mean, no,
and
no,
that
still
was,
no.
Like that was brought up in court, like when, because he tried to say self defense.
Yeah.
So when they put the they put somebody up there like with the law enforcement. So, you know, his lawyer was like, so if somebody comes to your family house shooting.
Oh, that was Secret Service.
Yeah, Secret Service. He was like, you wouldn't shoot back? He said, no. He said, I'm a duck. I'm going to take cover, find the threat, then I'm going to shoot.
Okay.
I'm never just
spray.
Yeah.
And that makes a big difference.
Yeah.
You got to take cover. You got to find that threat. Then when you shoot, that's when it's self-defense.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? You just out there just blowing that. No, that's not self-defense.
You just shooting.
You know what I'm saying? Then if it was just came to you, how you made it sound like it just came to you. That man called you 14 times. That man that told you what's going on. That man that let you know what's going on. You know what I'm saying? So it's just like, it's a whole nother ball game. It's a whole nother ball game. That like, he real, but he like, that ain't real as you swear it is, because real niggas gonna take accountability for what they did.
Yeah.
They gonna stand on it. Yeah, well, like, I shot, I ain't hit my target. I hit a little kid. That's the reality. That's the reality. But the hands of one, the hands of all.
Mm-hmm.
And that was brought up.
And that's just down there.
Yeah. And as I say, you say you knew it was his bullet, so, I mean, justice. I mean, he
That's his.
I think that's what sealed the deal for everybody. Like, the numbers matched. The numbers that came out of your mouth matched the numbers that came out of her head.
Mm-hmm.
That was the fourth story. That was the fourth story after two lie detector tests. I tell you, I'll shoot a 7.62 out there. Yeah, I will. Oh, that was the bullet that came out to Shia J head.
So, yes, I mean, like I say, if you didn't even mean to do it, you still did it.
Still did it. No matter if it's an accident or not, you still got to get justice served.
And then how did you feel so threatened to shoot? Like, come on, y'all. Y'all know how big them darn guns is, but his was like a pistol. Like that more fold or some junk, but that's so just long. Why'd you feel like the need to shoot that and you know all these trailers? Hell, call us. Hey, hit bug on Facebook, tell her to get out there high. Let us know. We'll get the fuck out y'all way. Yes. We would've got out y'all way. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? But ain't nobody think about it. It was more kids where they was than where we was. You know what I'm saying? Like they say he was throwing kids up under the, and that was his brother put on Facebook, ain't it? He was throwing kids up under the car. So, you know what I'm saying? It's like, you didn't think about nobody. You didn't care about nobody. And it ain't changes you. Y'all.
Yeah.
Some of y'all boys 18, y'all just had graduated.
And that's the sad part. That's what I'm saying. Discernment, like, cause 29, right? If you, why you even around 30, yeah. 30, why you even around people that didn't even graduate high school yet?
But I'm telling you, like from the facts, he wasn't around them.
It was two separate parties.
You feel me? Okay, yeah. Okay. That shit was brought to him. But when his people, his cousin came to his house and walked in, I mean, came to where he was and walked in the yard, that's what like.
That's when it started. The
yeah, but his cousin called him now before he got there and let him know what was going on already before he got there.
So he knew the situation and then he reacted the way he reacted. So like that's quote unquote premeditated right there. You knew what you was heading into and you knew if you're going how the situation was gonna pop out.
Exactly. Y'all still let this person come around and do whatever they want to do. Get in, do keep starting stuff. I don't understand it, but I ain't gonna try to understand it. I just want to get on here and say what I had to say because I don't want to talk about it no more. I'm not gonna say keep putting up statuses every day because it is what it is. And for me to grow, I just feel like I had to say what I gotta say and just take it with it. Whatever come with it, come with it. Oh, yeah. You know.
And like you said, you already know if you got anything else to say, anything, you know.
You can come on here anytime you want.
Anytime. Just like you said, you hit us up yesterday.
We like,
You know, I live in Charleston, so like I say, this was impromptu podcast. Like I said, we working hard out here. Not that I'm missing it, but I'm just saying, like I say, when people say that you want to come on, I'm like, I drive down today. I got to make this happen because, like I say.
When I start getting them screenshots, all these things, I was like, oh. I ain't know which one of y'all was hitting up. I'm like, hey.
Yo, I have you here, but okay, I would have saw it.
Hey, I see yo, shit.
I don't want to be on Facebook a little bit more.
We appreciate you coming on, Shea, because I say this is exactly what we built this platform for, is to get this voice, get the people that we know and amplify other people's voices. That
so you get their opinion out here in the world.
But like you can get your snap, I mean your social media, so you can let these people know where they can find you, especially the snap since you said
you out here twerking and stuff.
You gotta have a wristband.
Gotta have the wristband.
I got one.
My snap, let me tell y'all.
I got rubber band.
My Facebook. I'm about to delete my Facebook for a little bit. But my snap is how you tell it?
The ghost, ain't it? In the top left corner, little circle in the top left.
You know them young boys know it.
No ghost.
Well, I ain't mean a ghost, but
what?
Top left. Hit the top left.
This?
No, left. Left. This? Yeah, up there. Hit that.
Oh, okay.
Look at
which
me.
Which one I tell them? I don't tell them. The last one. Oh, it's LLSHYA4EVAA. That's Long Live Shia. Forever. With the letter 4 and 2 A's, okay? And I might add y'all back. Huh. My Instagram is ShellStillStandn.
Huh.
My Facebook is Shell J.
It's a great idea.
I don't know my TikTok, but yeah.
And y'all can follow me at Y-Twin because on Twitter, Instagram, you can follow me at Hassani underscore guy on the snap. Hey, Shell, you know Hassani mean in Swahili?
What it mean?
It mean handsome, and I'm that guy, man. What it mean? Cap-ass nigga.
Cap-ass nigga. Cap-ass nigga. You?
Go ahead, Jeremy.
Oh, Jeremy. My bad. Twitter at DJeremyGant. Snap and IGJeremy.Gant. All right, my Twitter is SuperJuice12. That's Super, S-U-P-A. You can't spell juice, that's on you. So you can follow the snap, the JuicePat12. Follow the IG as King Cobra with 2 K's.
Oh, my. Go ahead. I think my Kira underscore Kira 13 on snap and Instagram. Kira Will on Facebook. I ain't got Twitter no more.
I know Brad ain't going to go. So you can follow me on IG and Twitter at the Money QB. You can follow me on Snapchat, Fine Ass Twin. Follow the Navy Black Podcast on IG and Twitter at Navy Black Pod. Go to Facebook, Navy Black.
go to YouTube, subscribe, and like our video. Get our views up. I know y'all gonna check this out because y'all want to be messy and y'all like to hear what shit they say.
Yeah, they gonna be on this one.
So go to the YouTube Navy Black Podcast. Also, if you want a shirt or something like that, go to NavyBlackPodcast.com. We got the merch there, and you can see our pretty faces on the website. Man. I'm just letting you know, man. I mean, you can't get fresh like your boy, but you can get a nice shirt and it will fit good on your body. We like how it look on your body, man. Navy Black.
Apparel. You heard Shakira say she ain't no Twitter no more, man.
I don't either. Who does Twitter?
Shakira gave us a list.
All right. This ain't about me.
I was saying this yesterday. Highlight. I made my baby mama deactivate her Twitter, anyway. And Jared did the same thing. My boy. Baby Black Podcast, baby.
There you go.
All right. There you go.
The boy had to throw a little spice in there before we left. Yeah, you want to talk shit? You want to run your mouth? Look at you like your motherfucking house. We're going to set this bitch off.
Yeah, definitely. Seeing the net getting moving.
Dropping it hard.
But thank you for, like, you know, choosing us for you to come talk to and stuff. I was so excited when you had hit me yesterday, you know. I appreciate it. You know, you my high school crush and stuff like that. You know how I eat.
So yeah, trying to play a trick on me, y'all. We told
y'all about that last time. Yeah, so you know, so I'm glad I wasn't here whenever y'all had asked that question too. I meant to tell y'all that.
Why?
Your high school crush?
Yeah.
Okay.
Who your high school crush was?
Huh?
Who your high school crush was?
You said you brought it up.
No. I wasn't in high school with Shell J.
Oh, you were. I'm older than him. He a little young boy.
Who's your high school crush?
My high school?
Yeah.
So we talk from ninth grade.
Yeah.
We talking.
Don't lie.
Y'all know her too well.
Man, say her name.
Y'all know her well.
What's her name?
Cousin of y'all.
What her name?
Who? We're going to just leave it at that.
No,
we'll leave it at that.
How you?
Leave it alone.
You done draw the same time, man.
I got a lot of cousins.
She was in high school with you, the same grade?
No, your grade.
Whoa. Grade. I know what grade you talking about. Nah. You about to call a tech.
You like to somebody in CO14?
Yeah, that's why I said I'm coming to your class reunion.
Okay, well, just tell me who it is. I might can put you down.
Not put me down. We're going to talk afterwards. Yeah, y'all can.
No, go ahead and tell me right now.
I mean, they should know. I done gave it away. What you call the tech for?
They couldn't.
Who? Yeah, she said
yeah, they
I already know
because
I know I
can
put you down.
Okay, it is. I might try. It's either a yes or a no. It don't hurt me.
Mrs. T, yeah, I done told you what's going
brown skin.
Definitely.
She got long hair. It's kind of like right here.
No,
like
she got
shoulder
that,
length.
No, she got that cute piercing though right there.
Oh, okay, I know he's talking about.
We ain't want to talk about that. We'll ask you this since you on here. You tell us your high school crush.
I don't think I had them. I was cool with all the cute boys, so I had a crush on me. You know, so, I ain't had no.
So then you had one that's like, you looked at like, maybe a little older than you, like, man, like.
No, I always thought, you know, y'all was okay. Chris Martin.
No camera.
I can't get no camera.
You can't get no camera,
Jerry.
Oh, wow.
Go to war,
now, when Chris Martin and KK used to walk through that gym when we was younger back in the days. Nah, yeah, them used to be ooh wee.
Mm-hmm. KK, so you like the bull, brother?
I didn't like them. I mean, just thought they were sexy. You know how you just be like, oh, this is sexy boys. Like,
I saw a picture on my aunt Snap today. He said her name was Samantha Straws. She was a baddie. Bad
I
John.
Saw the same picture. Though. I was like, yes.
She always been pretty though.
Yeah, she still is too.
Ain't
you like skinny?
Yeah.
What you trying to say?
Yeah,
I ride in that Jeep.
Ooh, y'all show our bad.
Clean it out, boy. Hey, but man, thank you again for coming on. We had a great time on the show today, man. This is dropping as soon as possible, man. This is the David Black Podcast. We'll see y'all next week. It is.
Oh, man. I know you're going to say what's on this, man. Fucking shit.